Hello class 10, today I am going to start a new chapter and the name of the chapter is Our Runaway Kite and this is part 1. So all of you take out your books to page number 37 and let's see the first part what it is written. Of course, there was nobody for us to play with all. The big half moon. So there was not many people who would be able to play with us on the big half moon. We had just to make the most of each other and we did. And we had to just make it most of each other. We tried to, try to do the best of each other and we did that. We live on the Big Half Moon Island. So they lived in an island named Big Half Moon Island. We are Father, Claude and I. So who are these we? There was Father, there was Claude and he himself and she herself. She here is the narrator. What is the name of the narrator? Philippa. Yes, here you will not get it right now, her name, but you're going to get her name eventually as the text proceeds. Aunt Esther, Mimi and Dick. So who were along with them? There was Aunt Esther, there was Mimi and there was Dick. It used to be only Father and Claude and I. So previously it was Father, Claude and Philippa only. It was all on account of the kite that there are more of us. It's only because of the kite that there are more of them. That is what I want to tell you about. And how we from 3 became 6. That is my story all about. And that is what I'm going to tell it to you about. Father is the keeper of the big half moon lighthouse. So Father is the keeper of the big half moon lighthouse. I am 11 years old. So Philippa is 11 years old. And Claude is 12. And Claude is 12 years old. In winter, when the harbor is frozen over, we all move over to the mainland. When the harbor is, frozen, they move to the mainland. As soon as spring comes, back we sail to our own dear island. And when there is spring, they again sail back to their own dear island. The funny part used to be that people always pitied us. So people always pitied them. When the time came for us to return, from mainland, they have to again return back to the island. People pitied them that, oh my God, how difficult is now life for you in that island. They said, we must be lonesome over there. So they said that they were very lonely over there with no other children near us. And there was no other children for them to play as well. Of course, Claude and I would have liked to have someone to play with us. We would love to have someone also to play with us. It is hard to run pyrite caves and things like that with only two. It's very difficult, to play these kind of games with only two people. But we used to quarrel a good deal with the mainland children in winter. So it was perhaps just as well that there were none of them on Big Half Moon. Claude and I never quarreled. So we used to, quarrel is also a part of childhood. So they used to quarrel with the children of the mainland because they would get no one to quarrel with again in the island. Claude and Philippa, they never ever quarreled with each other. To be sure, Father didn't seem to have any relation except us. So Father did not have anyone. This used to puzzle Claude and me. We were surprised that how is it possible that Father did not have any one of his relatives. Everybody on the mainland had relation. Everybody had relation. Why hadn't we? Why don't we have it? Was it because we lived on an island? We thought it would be so jolly to have an uncle, an aunt and some cousin. She thought that it would be so good to have some uncle, some aunt, some cousins. Once we asked Father about it, but he looked so sorrowful that we wished we hadn't. So much so that we wished that we hadn't ever asked him about his relations. He said it was all his fault. Why these had happened. Claude and I didn't understand what he meant. We did not understand that what he meant by it was all because of him. So here in this part, we come across Philippa and Claude, they are brothers and sisters. And Philippa is the narrator who is telling us the story. Okay, so previously there were 3 members. which has changed to 6 now. Father is the keeper of the big half moon, and you know, they never got any children to play with them. So people also used to pity them. They quarreled a lot with the mainland children, but never quarreled with each other because they got no one with them, okay, to be your dad. And then whenever he used to ask father about relation, okay, he used to become very sad, so much that they wished that they had never asked father regarding their relationship. Okay, so let's do the exercises that we have. The keeper of the Big Half Moon Lighthouse is Aunt Esther, Father, Claude, Dick. Father. The family moved over to the mainland in summer, spring, monsoon, winter. Winter. When asked about relations, father looked happy, angry, sorrowful, irritated. Sorrowful. Fill in the chart, then you have, this is a different thing, where there will be two parts. Suppose name of the island. Here you have to fill it. So what will you write? What is the name of the island? Big Half Moon Island. Okay, so like this, any question can be given. Suppose age of Claude, 12. Okay, so things like this can also come. Then the game they played by Claude and the narrator, Pirates Cave and all those games that are mentioned, that you can write. People felt that Claude and narrator were lonesome in the island. True. So here the answer will be that they said, we must be so lonesome over there with no other children near us. Claude and Philippa quarreled. So that is false. Claude and I never quarreled. That is the proper supporting statement. Next, nobody on the mainland had relation. This one, the answer will be everybody on the mainland had relation. So students, I have completed doing the exercises also, and also you have done part 1. In my next video, I shall continue with the next portion. Thank you.